Greetings, welcome back to another video of Sapphire Academic, dealing with death of another rapper. I'm going to get into a little bit of the history and how it relates to another rapper, because I think it's important to talk about this aspect, because we touch on the drill aspect a little bit of it. But before I begin, just want to say rest in peace. Just want to say, just because I'm mentioning this drill aspect doesn't necessarily mean this is the reason why this happened to anybody mentioned in this video. So just go here, go on the rundown. This happened about a week ago. This rapper is about to assign to Lil Uzi. Was about to sign to Kodak Black as well too. But let me just go through this, and I'm just going to go a little bit through the history. So an up-and-coming female rapper from Memphis, Tennessee, was gunned down after she posed in Instagram photos with loads of cash. Police say aspiring rapper Lotta Cash Desto was shot and killed during an armed robbery in Houston, Texas, early Saturday. Desto, real name Destiny Govan, was driving a Porsche SUV with a 20-year-old female passenger at around 2:30 a.m. when a four-door sedan pulled alongside the SUV at a red light. Police say two men hopped out of the car and exchanged gunfire with Gavan, 25, who was shot multiple times and robbed. She was pronounced dead at the scene. The female passenger was transported to a local hospital with a single gunshot wound. Police say officers found Christian Isaiah Williams, 24, in a nearby parking lot suffering from a gunshot wound to the abdomen. He was transported to a hospital where he was charged with murder, according to Fox 26 News. He remains hospitalized. So he tried to get the bag, and he ended up getting a gun wound and a murder charge. Police say evidence left at the crime scene links Williams to the double shooting. The second gunman is still at large. Govan was known for collaborations with mentor Lil Uzi Vert on her rap songs Lunchroom and Vegas. So this was reported by Lovely TTV. So this aspect I want to get into, as it relates to another rapper, of rappers getting involved with other people's beefs. So Julio Fulio is beefing with another Florida rapper named Youngin Ace. So Julio Fulio is with a crew called KTA. I'm not going to mention the name of the group, what it means. And Youngin Ace is with a group called ATK. I know it sounds similar, I know it sounds confusing, but there are tons, dozens and dozens of video with this information out there. So the internet police work is already been done. It's already out there. So I'm not doing any police work. I'm just reporting on the police work already done. So that's the main thing to know. There's a lot of, I guess, backstory to this whole entire situation, but really, the beef didn't get mainstream until Youngin Ace dropped a diss called Who I Smoke, dissing many of Julio Fulio's homies. But what really got the song in the spotlight was that Youngin Ace used a song from, I forgot the name, but hold on. So the song that was sampled was Vanessa Carlton, Thousand Miles. So, da, 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 da. And I see you, da, 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 and I miss you. So they really sampled that song to do a drill song. This song is actually the height of Florida drill, the most popular. So Julio Fulio came out with his song, and he sampled When I See You. So this was, you could say, drill gone Disneyland, to say the least. I mean, that's pretty much the way I'm trying to put it. They took a beat that was They took a pop beat, a very popular pop beat. I mean, Young and Ace, the way he did the song, I don't want to get too sidetracked, but this was the height of, I don't want to say this was the height of the beef, but this was the mainstream introduction to the beef, because once this got into the streaming sphere, it really got a lot of eyeballs onto the situation that wasn't normally there. So that's what I mean, it went mainstream. So Julio Fulio, they've been dissing each other back and forth, certain songs. So Lotta Cash Desto decided to do a song with Julio Fulio. I'm just gonna play some of it to show where the diss is.
Taking trips, pop out with niggas. I see too much, I need meat. He got some bowls, took off for three. Now I'm smoking exotic weed. The off back to back look like trees. Play come and lay mud on my jeans. I'm with Fulio slang Jeep. And he got me smoking on leak.
So Leaky Pack. So this is one of Fulio's ops. Rest in peace. So she mentioned that. So this got her involved in the beef. So this was January 27, 2021. So people could say that she didn't know what she was saying. A lot like that Young MA situation with the whole Tuca. Like Tuca is very popular in Chicago slang, which got into rap slang, drill slang, right? And a lot of people outside of Chicago don't know that Tuca is an actual person. So people try to say that, oh, sort of the same situation. But they did do a video, because this was more of a, I wouldn't say this was a video. This wasn't the official video, but they did do an official video. She does the same thing essentially. So you can't really say that she didn't know who Leaky was at this point.
We love you, taking trips, pop out with niggas. I see too much, I need meat. He got some bowls, took off for three. Now I'm smoking exotic weed. The off back to back look like trees. Play come and lay mud on my jeans. I'm with Fulio slang Jeep. And he got me smoking on leak.
Yeah, so they put it out twice, two times. But this is interesting. But I'm gonna get into it as I go forward. I'm gonna play this video. This is from It's Lit TV. Shout out to It's Lit TV for this information. So I'm gonna play this video.
What's up, gang? It's Frightline, and I'm back with another. So today, gang, we speaking on Desto, you know, Desto, Lotta Cash, Desto, artist out of Orange Mound, Memphis, you know, but she was currently residing in Houston, Texas, you know, basically working on her music and starting over things like that network. But, you know, a lot of people speaking on this, and the media, they ran and jumped and did a story, but they never really didn't break it down and give y'all the full details. But, you know, we got y'all here, this Lit TV, man. I'm gonna break it down and let y'all understand what's really going on, because I know y'all looking like, damn, just a female rapper got killed. No, it's way more going on than just what the image in the media is gonna paint. So we're gonna start all the way from the beginning, which was over a year ago. If y'all don't know, Lotta Cash Desto was dating Cuban Dolls, which was JayDaYoungan's woman at the time. JayDaYoungan and Cuban Doll got into it. They broke up or whatever. This is the woman that that left JayDaYoungan for her. Now while she's out here residing in Houston, she links up with Fulio and does a song. And in the song, I'm gonna run that clip for y'all. She's speaking on dead ops and dead people in Florida that she's never met before in her life, all off of the script of doing a song with Fulio. Fulio.
See, that's the problem there. And again, I'm not saying this is the reason why he was killed, RIP, but these rappers getting into another rapper's beef, it really should be a cautionary tale to all the fans that are hyping this beef up, because the beef really has nothing to do with us. But the problem is they put music on it. And they put it in a way where they'll play it in the clubs. That's why I was saying that those two songs went mainstream, and then it just kept eyeballs on them. And then it just created this after effect of now we're watching to see what happens next. It's interesting because it seems like police are just watching and just building a RICO case to take both of these crews down. I mean, that's my prediction anyways, but the police are watching. They're seeing everything going on social media. I mean, it should be a well-known fact at this point now, but I'll continue.
Those distant ops or whatever the case may be. So she protecting that and she started distant ops saying she's smoking on Leaky and this and this and that, yada yada yada. But at the end of the day, you know that's not right. And I do have artist JayDay Breezy speaking on that also.
Man, first of all y'all mad about this dead ass dyke, which I don't give a fuck. This hoe way from motherfucking Memphis, this and my dog from Jacksonville. We don't even know this hoe. This hoe got on the beach on some cool shit, talking about she smoking Leaky. Fuck that bitch, nigga. I don't give a fuck, nigga. Then y'all talking about some motherfucking clout chasing. What the fuck I'm a clout chasing all that bitch for? This hoe don't even get views on fucking YouTube. This hoe don't even get paid for her fucking music. What the fuck? Bitch, YouTube views low as shit. Whole streams low as shit. Y'all talking about clout chasing. Man, y'all better, man, find somebody to play with. Last thing I'm saying, I'm off this topic. I really don't give a fuck about this shit. But for you Memphis niggas that feel some type of way about her or her homies to be exact, y'all supposed to be real street niggas. Y'all sit around this bitch and portray yourself like y'all real street niggas. So a real street nigga would have drew the line when y'all heard her hop on that song and was, oh, smoking on such and such. But nah, y'all approved of that shit though. That's not no real street shit. Y'all should have told her, nah, we ain't doing that. We ain't finna jump in no another nigga beef. Hell nah, man. That's lame. But now, some tragic shit happened. Now niggas speaking on her, y'all feel some type of way. Nah, that's not how that work. If y'all gonna be real all the way to fuck around.
So this is this was on Instagram. He's saying basically where was everybody when she was saying this. So he's basically saying Memphis, anybody from Memphis should just hold the L essentially, because she was dissing people that she didn't even know. And now look how she ended up. And now they're dissing her in return. So it's interesting about the whole situation with JayDaYoungan, because he was also killed as well too, about, I think it's been about a month ago. Didn't do a video on that, but found the opportunity here because It's Lit TV mentioned that Cuban Doll left JayDaYoungan and got with a lot of cash. So I don't know if that has anything to do with anything. Maybe it's just a coincidence. But Cuban Doll, I mean, she's been with 6ix9ine, so that's all I really gotta say about Cuban Doll. Yeah, so that's Cuban Doll. So I did find, you know, a history of JayDaYoungan and Cuban Doll. I didn't really find much on Cuban Doll and Lotta Cash, just that one video, it seems like. So I don't know if that really has anything to do with anything, but it's interesting because JayDaYoungan was also jumped into the beef in Florida with Julio Fulio and Youngin Ace. Now, it's interesting because JayDaYoungan, he did a lot more dissing than Lotta Cash, because Lotta Cash, all she did was that those two videos. I don't think she really did anything on Instagram. I don't think she really took it to a new level. But JayDaYoungan, he hopped on the track with Youngin Ace and K-Su. And K-Su's been notorious for dissing Fulio's homies, especially Bibby. Bibby's like one of the main people that they diss. Here is JayDaYoungan on Instagram dissing Bibby, Fulio's boy.
And they gave me some more shit. Like, they gave me some shit. They told me to take these bitches like four times. They don't.
So I'm not sure what this is.
One of these every 3 hours. If you familiar with this, let me know.
Now, I wouldn't be surprised if he was just tweaking on the pills. Look what he's doing, but then we're going to see what he does next. So basically, he has the Bibby jersey. K-Su's notorious for using the Bibby jersey to diss Julio's boy. Bibby. He was named Bibby, the basketball player Bibby. So they use the jersey. They disrespect the jersey. So essentially, he's saying he's smoking on Bibby, pretty much, right? Smoking on Bibby. So this was what was going on, what JayDaYoungan was doing before he got shot himself. He was dissing heavy on tracks, off tracks. This is a picture of him on Instagram with the Bibby jersey again, just to show that the Bibby jersey was a big way to diss Bibby. So this was Fulio. It's interesting that Fulio said this about JayDaYoungan, but he had somebody, he had a lot of cash, essentially not doing, she was doing the same thing, but not to the extent. She was on a music video, JayDaYoungan was in a music video, but seems like JayDaYoungan took it to the whole new level on Instagram and everything, continuing on the disrespect. It's one thing to be cool with a side. It's another thing to take on that side's beef, essentially. And I think another thing was JayDaYoungan, he called himself 23. That's one of his nicknames. And then Youngin Aces, former homies, was named 23 as well, too. There's a story of Youngin Ace getting shot with three of his other homies. They all died and he survived. One of them was named 23. So that's who Fulio continuously gets at when he does his diss songs. He disses 23 and a few others. So there's a lot of tension with this beef, and outside rappers are getting involved. And then when they get killed, all people are going to bring up, whether any side did it or not, they're just going to bring up the dissing that was happening. That's all these rappers get remembered for. Lotta Cash, she didn't do as much dissing, but the same thing happened. They dug up what she said in the past, and they used it against her, unfortunately. So here's a video of essentially Fulio saying the same thing as J-Dot Breezy, what he said about Lotta Cash. We have Fulio saying the same thing about JayDaYoungan.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? Man, y'all tuning in to Get Hip TV. And as y'all can see from the title, we got Fulio reaction to JayDaYoungan passing away. So stay tuned to see what Fulio had to say. But before we get into the video, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay hip whenever I post. But all right, y'all, let's get into it. So Jacksonville rapper Fulio and Louisiana rapper JayDaYoungan didn't see eye to eye. And the big reason for that is because JayDaYoungan rocked with Fulio's biggest op, Youngin Ace.
Yeah, Youngin Ace also gave JayDaYoungan a ATK chain as well, too. So there was a lot of, I guess, respect between the two in terms of how they viewed this, how they viewed the beef.
And according to Fulio on his live, he spoke about his problem with JayDaYoungan being that he's from out of town, but he cool with Youngin Ace and kind of put himself in a beef by dissing Fulio homies. So now that JayDaYoungan passed away, Fulio was quick.
I'm actually really excited about this.
Quick to share his thoughts on Instagram. Before Fulio went live, he shared this on his Instagram. RP JayDaYoungan.
Yeah, just being facetious. So this is the same video that JayDaYoungan was in with K-Su and Youngin Ace. Even the names too is similar. JayDaYoungan, Youngin Ace. So I mean, just off the strength of the parallels alone, there was a lot of parallels already, I think, gravitated them towards each other.
You will be missed, LOL. Then followed with another post saying, dude used to diss me just to be cool with the ops. Even got them boys' name tatted. Now look, with a laugh.
Yeah, it's crazy how things come full circle, because now the same fate came for a lot of cash. Even though she didn't do as much dissing, she did participate. She didn't know anybody. And look at the end result. People are not blaming this beef on it, but they are mentioning it. They are bringing it up. The way that J-Dot Breezy brought it up, Julio's bringing it up for JayDaYoungan. So JayDaYoungan died first. He died earlier, a few months ago, or maybe a couple of months ago now. Lotta Cash died a few weeks ago.
Half an emoji. So then Julio went live alone and then joined someone else live and spoke on the situation. So I'm gonna roll clips of both of them so y'all can see it.
Listen. When think about it like this. Think about it like this, brother. Say if you from out of town, right? You from out of town. I'm from Jacksonville though. Me and my aunt, we from Jacksonville. You from out of town, right? So you see what we got going on. So just cause you rocking with a rapper, you rocking with a nigga that don't me. You act like you my aunt now. You know what I'm saying? So now you act like you my aunt. Now you dissing me in songs, saying Elf my dad, homeboys, this and that. How I'ma feel? What I just supposed to sit back, just, you know what I'm saying? Be quiet. Don't say nothing. If it was me on the other end, they would have did the same thing. They would have turned up. You know what I'm saying? This man used to wear the baby jerseys. He used to wear the baby jerseys out.
Bringing up the baby jerseys.
Like, she done diss me in songs. I don't even smoke weed though, but I'm smoking a J-Bay. I'm smoking a J-Bay, man. Yeah. This man get the arts tatted. He get arts, he get ATK, he get it tatted, he get 20, like. That's weird, bro. So now I'm smoking 223 shit. Royale and J-Jan Royale. 44 Lee, what is that, brother?
So the cycle continues. The feds are watching. And all I really have to say is that the streets is the hellfire. The streets is the hellfire. It's I don't think at this point it's gonna be a issue of how to clean up the streets. There's no way to clean up the hellfire. Another name for the hellfire is Satan's safe space. One more time, Satan's safe space. That's what the streets is. It's essentially a place where Satan can thrive. He feels safe. He's with his people, he's with his soldiers. And essentially, either you're going to get swallowed by the hellfire, by the Satan safe space, or you're going to avoid falling in it. And essentially, that's what you have to do. That's what the people coming up, the older generation, has to keep the younger generation out of, because it's easy to get sucked in. Two rappers, don't know what exactly happened, but they got involved in this, and now this is part of their legacy. So that's all I gotta say. Peace out to the next video. RIP to the fallen soldiers on both sides, every side. Stay off the hellfire. Stay out of Satan's safe space. Peace out.